This video shows you how support groups are used in BMC Remedy ITSM and provides some basic information about how they are configured. After watching, you should be able to determine which support groups to create for your environment and what information to gather before creating them. A support group consists of one or more people who provide support within an organization, and the group might be internal or external to the organization. You use support groups in ITSM to assign work, route approvals, send notifications, and control access. For example, incident requests and tasks are assigned to a support group. A support group is authorized to approve change requests and can be notified when the status of a configuration item, or CI, changes. You might divide your support organization into groups based on technical knowledge, such as service support, application support, and networking support, or based on geography or some other business requirements. A person can be a member of multiple support groups with one specified as their default group. Next, you'll see how support groups are used across the ITSM applications, starting with those uses that are common to all applications. You can view your profile to see which support groups you are a member of and the functional roles you perform for each of them. In the main console of all ITSM applications, you can filter the displayed records based on your support groups. Here, the user Alan Albrook displays all the incident requests for CalBro services that are assigned to his service desk group. For many types of requests, you can assign a support group and designate a specific person as the assignee. You can either do this manually or configure ITSM to auto-assign a group and an assignee to the request. Only a member of the assigned group, in this case back office support, can be the assignee. Groups and people can be assigned to high-level requests such as this problem, incidents, changes, and releases, and also to lower-level requests such as tasks, work orders, and CI unavailability records. Some types of requests have additional roles, such as owner or manager, that can be given to a group and person. For example, a problem request has a coordinator group and problem coordinator, which in this case were automatically assigned to the submitter and his default support group. You configure a support group for automatic assignment based on the type of assignment and the associated request's organization, location, operational categorization, and product categorization. This example record automatically assigns CalBro's back office support group as the problem coordination group for mainframe failures within their company. You can create templates for several types of requests, such as this change request template for upgrading a hard drive, to pre-populate certain fields and reduce the time needed to create a request. For a template to be available to a user who is creating or modifying a request, one of that user's support groups must be specified as a user of the template. Alan Albrook could select the Add Internal Memory to Server template in his change request because he is a member of the Change Management Support Group, one of those that uses the template. Alan also has the ability to modify the template because Change Management is specified as its authoring group. BMC Remedy ITSM enables you to send broadcast messages to your organization or customers so that users can view them from all ITSM applications. You can notify a particular support group or person of a broadcast message, just as Alan Albrook notified the service desk group of this message. You can also give one or more support groups permission to modify a message. The front office support group members can modify this message. You can also send a reminder to a particular support group or person. A reminder is similar to the notification for a broadcast message, but stands alone. You might send one to remind a group to check on a particular incident. BMC Remedy ITSM has two available views of most of its forms, a classic view that mimics older versions of the product and a newer best practice view, both shown here for a change request. You can specify which view should appear for a particular support group or person, overriding the view that the rest of the company sees. Here, Alan Albrook specifies that the service desk group will see change management forms in classic view. When working with a new incident request, you can use a script to help you record important information about the request. A script prompts you with actions and questions. A script is available to a user who is creating or modifying a request only if one of that user's support groups is specified as its author. Alan Albrook was able to select the hardware issue script for this incident because he is a member of the service desk support group, the authoring group for the script. A change request has several stages in its lifecycle that require approval, and you can specify support groups as approvers. Calbro's back office support group was added as an approver to this change request. In the asset management interface, you can relate a CI to a support group to show that the group is responsible for the CI. Users who are not asset administrators can modify only CIs related to their support groups. When creating a contract, you must specify a support group to manage it. You can optionally specify that only members of this group can view or modify the contract, as shown here. Before looking at configuring support groups, let's review the ways that they're used in ITSM. A support group can be assigned many types of requests, and these assignments can be made automatically or manually. It can use or author a template. It can receive a reminder and also notification of a broadcast message. It can see a form in a particular view. It can use and therefore author an incident script. It can approve a change. It can be responsible for supporting a CI. And it can manage a contract. To configure your support groups, from the Custom Configuration tab on the Application Administration console, choose Foundation, Organizational Structures, and then Support Groups. A group must be part of an organization, which must be part of a company. For example, your company might contain organizations for both IT support and HR, and the IT support organization might contain several support groups, including back office support and service desk. You must assign each group a role from a hierarchy that starts with help desk at the lowest level. When someone from a group with a help desk role submits or is assigned an incident, that person also becomes the incident owner. Use the line of business role for a group outside of IT that supports customers with a particular business need. If you have an email alias that distributes email messages to everyone in a support group, you can improve the performance of notifications by using that alias to notify the group rather than notifying each member individually. You can specify business hours and holidays for a group so that the group and its members will not be assigned work or receive notifications when they are not on duty. But you can designate a support group as on-call, which allows the group's members to receive pager notifications of events that occur outside of normal business hours. A support group's business hours are also used to calculate the earliest start date for a change request. When planning your support groups, consider which groups of people share responsibility for specific types of tickets, who needs to be notified when tickets are escalated, and who will be responsible for managing the membership of each support group. Someone with an in-depth understanding of your support organization's processes, including any external support providers, should be involved. We hope this video has helped you understand how support groups are used in BMC Remedy ITSM and the basics of how they are configured. Thank you for watching.